You may think of LA as a huge modern city that didn't really have anything before tons of cars and Hollywood stars. But right in the heart of the city are around a dozen active tar pits that hold the secrets of LA's past 50,000 years. Welcome to the world-famous La Brea Tar Pits, a museum, a research lab, and the only Ice Age fossil site in the world that's being actively excavated in a city. And our guide is the site director and paleoecologist, Dr. Emily Lindsey. Her mission is to find out how climate change, human activities, and the loss of big animals may impact our planet. And the La Brea Tar Pits may have trapped the answer.
So what did LA look like 50,000 years ago? Please tell me there was less traffic than there is right now.
Well, there was a lot of traffic through this area, but no cars. The LA Basin had a huge variety of animals during the Ice Age. We had mammoths and mastodons, we had saber-toothed cats and direwolves, we had the American lion, jaguars, giant ground sloths, horses, bison, camels, all kinds of big animals. And we know that they were all, at some point, walking through this very spot where you and I are standing, because we find their bones right here in this park. The sloths that we find here got to be like the size of hippopotamuses.
What?
Like, they're just enormous.
Scientists aren't exactly sure why certain animals like the giant ground sloth went extinct while other animals didn't. That's why this research is so important.
We're standing on top of a big oil field right now. It's about 1,000 feet beneath our feet. LA has some earthquakes sometimes. Those earthquakes cause cracks to open up in the ground where some of that oil actually gets smooshed up to the surface and spreads out and makes these little pools on the ground. And as those pools get bigger and bigger, they're able to trap animals that sometimes were as big as mammoths.
So animals were just walking around during the last ice age, you know, doing their own thing, and then all of a sudden they get stuck in this little pit, which they don't even realize is a tar pit.
Basically, that's right.
Well, yeah. I'm ready to see some fossils. Can we go?
Let's go.
The fossils are dug out of pits like these, and then carefully separated from the tar to reveal the past.
So what kind of fossils are we looking at now?
This right here is the upper front leg of a ground sloth.
That's huge.
We've got the same bone down there from a saber-toothed cat. Got the same bone over here from a dire wolf. Then we also have a rib over here of a bison or a horse.
That's really cool. So this must make you very excited.
Absolutely. I mean, it's just, you don't usually get fossil deposits like this, where you have just an incredible wealth of fossils tightly packed together.
The tar pits captured tons of live animals, and the tar helps to preserve their fossils in ways like no other. And today, scientists repair and study those fossils back at the fossil lab while visitors watch.
Well, as exciting as the big saber-toothed cat skulls and other huge mammal fossils are, I think just as exciting are the small things that we can really only see well under magnification. You want to take a look?
Of course I want to take a look. Let's see. Oh, wow.
Microfossils like the rodent teeth and juniper seed I'm looking at now are super small, but they tell a big story about LA's past.
A lot of the big animals that we find, the dire wolves and the mammoths, we find those species all over North America, sometimes even in South America, in many different types of ecosystems, so they don't tell us a lot about what it was like right here. But certain species of insects or plants or small mammals or birds or shells can tell us a lot about how cold or dry or hot or wet it was. We don't have juniper in the LA area today. It only lives at higher elevations in this part of California. And so we know that at the time that these fossils were falling into the tar pits, it must have been a little bit cooler here.
That's amazing.
Having this story, the past of Los Angeles, can really help us understand and predict and plan for what might be happening going into the future.
That is extremely fascinating.
This place is cool, so I'm gonna stick around, but I'll stay away from the tar.